This is Robert Ian with GoldSeek.com Radio. A Wall Street Journal story about a dentist with over $1 million in student loans has received significant coverage this week across talk radio and from various policy institutions. The basics of this story discuss how a dental school graduate borrowed just over $600,000 for graduate school and living expenses, and how that debt has now grown to over $1 million through the magic of compound interest working against you. And even though he is now on a 25-year government repayment plan at 7.25% interest, the debt will never actually be repaid, and will in fact grow to over $2 million over the life of the loan, at which point it will be forgiven, even though he will have paid in $1.6 million in payments at that point. The debt forgiveness in 25 years, at today's tax rates, could cost the dentist another $700,000 in income tax payments. There's so much that's wrong with this story, at so many different levels, that it would take 4 or 5 commentaries to effectively address all the intertwined issues. From overpriced universities to why interest rates on graduate loans were so high compared to 2% and 3% interest rates elsewhere in the economy during that same period, to the assumption that one can actually plan economically for the next 25 years, to the modern financial concept of indentured servitude, to an IRS that may still be lurking at the end of the 25-year repayment plan to pile on more debt in the form of taxation, to the idea that most student debt can no longer be discharged in bankruptcy. But one comment by the dentist's wife in the Wall Street Journal article said in part that the dentist and his wife concluded dental school was a good investment given the salary he expected to earn. She said, "We can make this work. There are certain things that are okay to go in debt for, like a house, an education, a car. But let's stop right there and examine those beliefs. Those very beliefs may have been the standard their parents adhered to in very different economic times, with costs and debt levels significantly lower. But given today's economic volatility and massive global debt levels, is that really sound advice? For $600,000 in tuition costs, one might have hoped some kind of economic education might have been included at the prestigious university this gentleman attended. But hoping doesn't make it so, and wouldn't necessarily be in the university's interest to create awareness and possibly doubt about the future economic viability of what they are selling, which is, in essence, a kind of Ponzi scheme, when debt is easy to get and hard to pay off. The casualty in all of this is time and freedom. What if, God forbid, the dentist or his wife have a change in their health situation down the road? What if his industry changes? What if he decides he doesn't like dentistry and wants to do something else with his life? Debt of that magnitude and under those terms limits choices and opportunities. Spend your time, your freedom, and your life wisely. And until next time, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com. Thanks, Chris.
Okay, Robert, thanks for another excellent installment. Well, that wraps up this week's GoldSeek.com radio episode. for two new big guests. Be sure to check out next week's show. Until we talk to you again, have a great week.